Someday, yes.
How about now?
You almost killed me.
Come on, where's your sense of fun?
Oh, it's fun, you want? And with Moses, you've always looked up to me.
Yeah, but there's not much of a view.
Second born, second place.
Not for long.
Suppose we'll get in trouble for this.
No, not a chance.
Why did the gods torment me with such reckless, destructive, blasphemous son?
Father, hear what I say.
Be still. Pharaoh speaks. I seek to build an empire, and your only thought is to amuse yourselves by tearing it down. Have I taught you nothing?
You mustn't be so hard on yourself, Your Majesty. You're an excellent teacher.
It is not your fault that your sons learned nothing.
Well, they did learn blasphemy.
True.
Father, the fault is mine. I goaded Ramesses on, so I am responsible.
Responsible? And do you know the meaning of that word, Ramesses?
I understand, Father.
And do you understand the task for which your birth has destined you? The ancient traditions? When I pass into the next world, then you will be the morning and the evening star.
But one damaged temple does not destroy centuries of tradition.
But one weak link can break the chain of a married dynasty. You have my leave to go.
But Father, Father, you know it was really my fault. Must you be so hard on him?
Moses, you will never have to carry a burden like the Cromwell Pastrams. He must not allow himself to be led astray. Not even by you, my son.
But all he cares about is your approval. I know he will live up to your expectations. He only needs the opportunity.
Maybe. Maybe so. Go now. I shall see you both tonight.
Well, that went well.
Just go away.
It could have been worse.
The weakling. That is what he called.
Well, you are rather pathetic.
Irresponsible, ignorant of the tradition. He practically accused me of bringing down the dynasty.
Oh, yes, I can see it now. There go the pyramids.
You can laugh about
it. Statues cracking and toppling over. The Nile drying up. Single-handedly, you will manage to bring the greatest kingdom on earth to ruin.
Tell me this, Moses. Tell me, is it that every time you start something, I'm the one who ends up in trouble?
Hey, I figured it out. You know what your problem is, Ramesses?
What?
You care too much.
And your problem is you don't care at all.
Well, in that case, I suppose you care a lot more than I do. That's we're late for a banquet, for example.
I'm done, for Father will kill me.
Don't worry, nobody will even notice.
Nobody will even notice.
Oh, the young princess. Ramesses, you are just named Prince Regent. You are now responsible for overseeing all the temples. I suggest you it over there, and thank you, Father. Apparently, Moses, someone thought he just needed the opportunity.
My Lord Pharaoh, I propose that the High Priest offer a tribute to the new regent.
An excellent idea. Hotep, hoi.
Hoi.
Hmm?
The maiden girl, how it?
By the power of Ra, we present for your delectation and delight an exotic apparition stolen from faraway lands. We offer you this delicate desert flower.
Let us inspect this desert flower. More like desert cobra.
Not much of a snake charmer, are you?
That's why I give him to you.
Well, that's quite generous, but...
I won't be given to anyone, especially an arrogant, pampered palace brat.
Are you going to let her talk to you like that?
You will show the proper respect for a prince of Egypt.
But I am showing you all the respect you deserve. None!
Be still!
I demand you set me free!
Be still!
Let me go!
As you wish!
You there! Have her sent to Prince Moses' chamber. If it pleases you, Father, my first act as regent is to appoint Moses as royal chief architect.
Guards!
Prince Moses?
Yes, sir.
There is a man tied up in my room. Well, look into it.
Right away, sir.
Please, I need water. I have a long journey ahead of me.
May God protect you.
Thank you.
Sorry, I'm so sorry. I didn't expect to see you here. Of all places that are there. At last.
At last?
Didn't I tell you, Aaron? Didn't I tell you? I knew he would return to us when he was ready.
Miriam, do you want this flow?
I know you care about that freedom.
Your freedom? Why would I care about that?
Because you're our brother.
What?
Didn't I ever told you?
Who? Never told me what.
But you're here, you must know.
Be careful, slave.
Oh my good prince, she is very exhausted from the days of work. And not that it was too much, we quite enjoyed it, but she's confused and knows not to whom she speaks.
I know to whom I speak, Ern. I know who you are, and you are not the prince of Egypt.
What did you say?
Your Highness, by her no heed, come, Miriam, I discuss something with you.
No, Ern, please, Moses, you must believe. You are born on my mother, you have it!
Stop it!
You're a brother!
How dare you! Young, you go too far. You shall be punished.
No, please, Your Highness, she's ill. She's very ill. We're begging your forgiveness. Please, Miriam, let's go!
No, Ern!
Our mother set you adrift in the basket to save your life.
Save my life? From who?
Ask the man who you call father.
How dare you?
God save you to be our deliverer.
No.
And you are Moses, you are deliverer.
Enough of this. You will regret this night.
Hush now, my baby. Misty love, don't cry. Sleep as your rock by the stream. Sleep and remember my last lullaby. So I'll be with you when you dream.
And all I've ever known, all I've ever wanted. Sweet perfumes of incense, red rooms of alabaster stone, all I've ever wanted. This is my home, with my father, mother, brother, oh so noble, oh so strong. Now I am home, here among my trappings and belongings I belong. And if anybody doubts it, they couldn't be more wrong. I am still a seven prince of Egypt, a son of the proud history that shone is on every wall. Surely this is all I've ever wanted, all I've ever wanted, all I've ever wanted.
with great numbers. They might have risen against us.
Father. Father, please. Tell me you didn't do this.
Moses, sometimes for the greater good, sacrifices must be made.
Sacrifices?
Oh, my son. They were only slaves. Moses?
Is this where you found me?
Moses, please try to understand.
So, everything I thought, everything I am, is a lie.
No, we are our son. And we love you.
But why did you choose me?
We didn't, Moses. The gods did. This is your home, my son. Here the river brought you, and he's here the river meant to be your home. Now forget and be content. When the God sent you a blessing, you don't ask why it was sent.
Last night, the gods granted me a vision. I'm not going to merely restore this temple. I will make it more grand, more splendid than anything else in Upper and Lower Egypt.
Get up, old man!
Look, fate has turned our little misadventure into a great opportunity. Father will be so pleased. This is just the beginning. A gateway will open an entire new city of white limestone, more dazzling than the sun.
Put your back into it!
And
faster!
Statue of Her, the god of the Nile. Two great column poles.
Stop it! Someone's got to stop
this!
There's nothing we can do.
Stop it! Stop! Leave that man alone!
Out of my way!
Over
who
there.
Did this?
Over there! Over there, it's him!
Moses!
Moses? the men.
We can take care of that. I can make it so it never happened.
Nothing you say will change what I've done.
I am Egypt. I am the morning and evening star. If I say day is night, it will be written. And you will be what I say you are. And I say you are innocent.
What you say does not matter. I can't stay here any longer.
No, wait!
No! Everything I know to be true is a lie.
Moses.
I'm not who you think I am.
What are you talking about?
Go and ask the man I once called father.
Moses.
Goodbye, brother.
Moses.
Your camels? Hot cut!
No!
Ephora! Pull! Hold on, we'll get you out!
Girls doing?
Trying to get that funny man out of the well.
Trying to get the funny man out of the well. Well, that's one I've never heard before. Oh my, oh, don't worry down there. We'll get you out. Hold on.
Don't worry, down there, we'll get you help.
Thank you.
ladies, please, you don't have to do this. I'm quite all right. Oh, that tickles. You've dimmed every inch of me. Oh, I was wrong.
Let me through, let me through. I want to see him. Oh, you are most welcome. You shouldn't be a stranger in this land. You have been sent as a blessing, and tonight you shall be my honored guest.
My father, Jethro, High Priest of Midian, come with me.
Hey, sit with me.
Okay.
My children, let us give thanks for this bountiful food. And let us also give thanks for the presence of the brave young man whom we honor here tonight.
Please, sir, I wish you wouldn't. I have done nothing in my life worth the honoring.
First, you rescued Sephora. Then you defend my younger daughters from brigands. You think that it's nothing? It seems to not what is worthy of honor. A single thread in a tapestry don't color brightly shine. Can never see its purpose in upon its grand design. And the stone that sits on the very top of the mountain's mighty face. It's more important than the stone that forms the base. So how can you see what your life is worth or where your value lies? You can never see through the eyes of man. You must look at your life. Look at your life through heaven. If a man loses everything he owns, he truly lost his worth. Or is it the beginning of a new and bright ever? So how do you measure the worth of man, your wealth or strength or size? And how much he gained, not how much he gave? The answer will come to him who tries to look at his life through heaven's eyes. Thus we shall only have you to the little to be found. When all you've got is nothing, there's a lot to go around. No last can escape being blown about by the winds of chance and chance. And all you never know all the steps, you must learn to join the dance. You must learn to join the dance. What he builds are vice. You can never see with your eyes on earth, but through heaven's eyes. Look at your life. Look at your life. Look at your life through heaven.
Thank you. Moses.
Here I am.
Take the sandals from your feet. The place in which you stand is holy ground.
Who are you?
I am that I am.
I don't understand.
I am the God of your ancestors, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob.
And what do you want with me?
I have seen the oppression of my people in Egypt, and I've heard their cries. So I have come down to deliver them out of slavery and bring them to a good land, a land flowing with milk and honey. And so unto Pharaoh I shall send you.
Me? Who am I to lead these people? They'll never believe me. They won't even listen.
I shall teach you what to say.
But I was their enemy. I was the prince of Egypt, a son of the man who slaughtered the children.
Who made man's mouth? Who made the deaf, the mute, the seeing, or the blind? Did not I? Now go. Oh, Moses, I shall be with you when you go to the king of Egypt. But Pharaoh will not listen. So I will stretch out my hand and smite Egypt with all my wonders. Shall be with you, Moses. 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 Moses.
Moses, you are just one man.
Sephora, please. Look at your people. They are happy. They're free. They have a promise of a life with dignity. This is what I want for my people. And this is why I must do the task that God has given me.
I'm coming with you.
Rameses? Moses? Is it really... Moses?
Rameses!
I thought you were dead.
Look at you, Pharaoh.
Well, look at you. What on earth are you dressed as?
Rameses, it's so good to see you.
Excuse me, Your Majesty. We are compelled to remind you this man has committed a serious crime against the gods.
We loathe to bring it up, mind you.
Yet the law clearly states the punishment for such a crime is...
death.
We hesitate to say.
Be still. Pharaoh speaks. I am the morning and evening star. I am Pharaoh.
Rameses.
It shall be as I say. I pardon forever all crimes of which he stands accused. And will have it known. He is our brother. Moses, the prince of Egypt.
Rameses, in my heart, you're my brother, but things cannot be as they were.
I see no reason why not.
You know, I'm Hebrew, and the God of the Hebrews came to me. He commands that you let his people go.
Commands? Hotep, Hoy, give my brother our answer.
Playing with the big boys, playing with the big boys, playing with the big boys, playing.
Okay, Moses. I know you. What's this really about?
Ramses. Look. What do you see?
A greater Egypt than of my father.
This is not what I see.
I cannot change what you see. I have to maintain the ancient traditions. I bear the weight of my father's crown.
Do you still not understand what Seth was?
He was a great leader.
His hands bore blood of thousands of children.
Slaves.
My people. And I can no longer hide in a desert while they suffer. At your hands.
So, you have returned only to freedom.
I'm sorry.
Yes, I had hoped. But I do not know this god. Neither I let your people go.
Ramses.
No! I will not be the weakling. Tell your people as of today their work loud has been done. Thanks to your god. Or is it thanks to you?
That you were one of us?
Don't listen to him.
No. He's right. I did not see because I did not wish to see.
Didn't see because you didn't wish to see. Well, that makes everything fine then, doesn't it?
Aaron, you shame yourself. Moses, hear what I say. I've been a slave all my life, and God had never answered my prayers until now. God saved you from the river. He saved you in all your wanderings. Even now, He saved you from wrath of Pharaoh. God will never abandon you. So don't you abandon us.
Ramses, let my people go!
Still knowing away at the born away.
Ramses, you cannot keep ignoring us.
Enough! I wish you no more of this heavy nonsense. Bring him to
me. Moses!
No!
the staff in your hand, Moses.
Yes, we are going to present the superior might of our gods. By the power of Ra.
Abundance vitale mission, Moses. I've endured you long enough. This must now be finished.
No, Rameses. It is only the beginning.
But Moses, didn't you see what's happened? The prize did the same thing. Pharaoh still has the power over our lives.
Yes, Aaron. Pharaoh has the power. He can take away your home, your food, freedom. With one word, he can take away your very lives. But there is one thing he cannot take away from you. Your faith. Belief. For we will see God's wonders. The chance to make you laugh was all I've ever wanted. And even now I wish that God could choose another, serving as your foe on his behalf. That's the last thing that I wanted. This was my home. All this pain and devastations with tortures me inside. All the innocent suffer from your stubbornness and pride. I send my sword. You know I call brother. Why must you pull down another blow?
I send my sword.
Let my people go.
Say the Lord.
come to hate me so? Is this what you want? Let my heart be hardened, and then mind how high the cost might go. This will still be so. I will never let your people go.
Rameses! Rameses.
Oh, let me guess. You want me to let your people go?
Rameses. We must bring this to an end.
Get out!
Rameses, please talk to me. We could always talk. This place, so many memories. I remember the time you switched the heads of the gods of the Temple of Ra.
If I recall correctly, you were switching heads right along with me.
No, I didn't do that. It was you.
Oh yes, you did. You put the sheep on the crocodile and the crocodile...
on the falcon.
Yes. The priest fought it's a horrible man and fasted 2 months. Father was fierce. You were always getting me into trouble. But then, you were always there to get me out of trouble again. Why can things be the way before?
Father! It's so dark and frightened. Why is he here? Isn't that the man who did all this?
Yes, but one must wonder why.
Because no kingdom should be made on the backs of slaves. Rameses, your stubbornness is bringing this upon Egypt. It would cease if you only let the Hebrews go.
I will not be dictated to. I will not be threatened. I am the morning and evening star. I am Pharaoh.
Rameses, something else is coming. Something much worse than anything before. Please, let contempt of life before it threatens everything hold you. Think of your son.
I do. You Hebrews have been nothing but trouble. My father had the right idea about how to deal with our people.
Rameses.
And I think it's time I finished the job.
Rameses!
And there shall be a great cry in all of the Egypt, such as ever has been, or ever will be again.
Rameses. You bring this upon yourself.
Thank you.
God has come to me again, saying, take a lamp, and with its blood, mark the intel and posts of every door. For tonight, I shall pass through the land of Egypt and smite all the firstborn. But when I see the blood upon your door, I will pass over you, and the plague shall not enter.
You and your people have my permission to go. Leave me.
effort so often proved in vain. Hope seemed like the summer birds, too swiftly flown away. Yet now I'm standing here, my heart so full I can't explain. Seeking faith and speaking words I never thought I'd say.
Thank you.
Soldiers!
Moses, look at your people. They are free.
Zespół taneczny Junior. Starszy zespół taneczny. W roli poganiaczy niewolników Max Kozerski, Max Kanak i Szymek Łaczmański. Faraon Seti i Królowa Tuja, Zuzia Kalinowska, Marysia Buczko. Kapłani, Hotep i Choj, Amelka Grajda, Mania Laitalainen. Królowa Nefertari oraz syn Ramzesa, Hania Wiśniewska, Lidia Łaczmańska. Madia nic cyzbuje, Ala Egert, Zuza Aniołowska. Siostry Sefory, Efora, Adżoli, Dofora i Jetrodiada, Domi Prokopowicz, Hania Karbowska, Ola Skrzypek. Jetro, Madzia Łaczmańska. Głos Boga, Karl Dolenz. Come please join us. Niewolnice i stare Madianitki, Danusia Wiśniewska, Maja Nowak-Kirmendi. Hebrajskie dziecko, Gabi Kielesz. Dorosły Aaron i Jochewet, Pola Janiec, Ala Rudowicz. Mali, Aaron i Miriam, Szymek Nowak-Kirmendi, Tosia Siwek. Miriam i Sefora, Gabi Górecka, Marianka Kubas. Ramzes i Mojżesz, Michał Łaczmański, Jeremi Zbudniewek. Teraz długa lista osób, których nie widać, ale chcemy was wszystkich na scenie, przynajmniej do wspólnego zdjęcia. Inspicjenci oraz garderobiany, Kosia Małek, Ola Bożek, Janek Ostapiuk, Antek Wilk, Marysia Śmietana. Brawa. Charakteryzacja, czyli sekcja beauty, Helena Wichary, Lena Chleb-Koszańska, Sandra Gozdek, Weronika Majewska. Asystent reżysera, bez którego ja już bym nie żyła, to Janek Konarski. Muzykę puszczał nam dzisiaj, jak zwykle, Maciek Bromirski. Brawa, Maciek. Za wspaniały dźwięk odpowiadał Marcin Ptak. Mikroporty to Maciek Chyła. Maciek, pokaż się. Oświetlenie oraz wizuale Damian Białorucki. Kolejna lista to nasi instruktorzy. Zapraszam wszystkich na scenę. Przygotowania aktorskie Asia Lewandowska. Zespół wokalny przygotowała Kasia Czałderna. Jak już jesteśmy przy zespole wokalnym, to zaproszę pierwszy raz w historii MET. Na scenie zabrzmieli też ojcowie dzieci i zapraszam tutaj Pawła Łaczmańskiego, Leszka Łaczmańskiego, Rafała Kubasa oraz Piotra Abramczyka. Zespół taneczny przygotowała nieobecna teraz Klaudia Borkowska, ale brawa dla pani Klaudii. Kostiumy i scenografię przygotowywała i dowodziła zespołem bardzo licznym Kasia Białobrzeska. W tym zespole są trzy wspaniałe osoby. To jest jedna z nich, Ala Egert, nasza tancerka i aktorka, która uszyła własnoręcznie większość z tych strojów. Ale pomogły nam również dwie wspaniałe krawcowe, pani Elżbieta Łaczmańska, zapraszamy serdecznie, oraz Ania Staniszewska. To były stroje kapłanów. Dzisiejszy musical był też nagrywany przez wspaniałą ekipę Morage TV, tak zwane MTV. Brawa dla was, dziękujemy. Chcemy na koniec tak podziękować też temu miejscu, Ośrodkowi Kultury i Sportu w Zielonce, za to, że możemy tutaj w tak ciepłym, w ciepłej atmosferze mieć te występy. Także bardzo dziękujemy panu Adamowi Lisieckiemu, Dariuszowi Baranowi z Okiso, z Zielonki.
No i na koniec podziękujmy pani Marcie. Zapraszamy na scenę. Oczywiście, zapraszamy. Zapraszamy.
Dziękuję bardzo. Dziękuję wam bardzo. I jeszcze na koniec chcemy podziękować bardzo panu Arturowi Abramowiczowi, nie widzę go, ale gdzieś tu pewnie jest, za to, że przez cały rok mogliśmy mieć zajęcia w ramach MET, za to, że mogliśmy dotrwać do tej premiery. Bardzo dziękujemy za wsparcie, za umożliwienie nam pracy w tym roku. Wielkie brawa.
To jeszcze pozwolę sobie dwa słowa wyrazić wdzięczność wszystkim. Gratuluję aktorom, wszystkim osobom zaangażowanym. Nie wiem, tak chciałem zapytać państwa, czy jeżeli ktoś się wzruszył, miał łezkę wokół, ręka do góry. Widzicie? Dostarczyliście nam tyle emocji. Posłuchajcie, no chciałem pani Marto bardzo serdecznie pani podziękować. My umówieni jesteśmy jeszcze jutro na tak pomiędzy dwoma spektaklami na jakieś takie krótkie spotkanie, więc będziemy sobie jeszcze dziękować. Natomiast chciałem też państwu, bo czy są tutaj jacyś rodzice, dziadkowie, babcie naszych aktorów, ręka do góry? No, to chyba większość z nas. Gratuluję i muszę powiedzieć, że cóż, możemy oczywiście wybrać się do Teatru Roma, do Teatru Studio Buffo, możemy wybrać się nawet na Broadway. I z pewnością będziemy mieli do czynienia z super artystami, wspaniałymi efektami i tak dalej, ale chciałbym tak od siebie powiedzieć, że tutaj dzisiaj stało się, jak co roku, dzieje się coś niezwykłego, bo poza kunsztem aktorskim, na miarę możliwości naszych młodych aktorów, mogliśmy dzisiaj zobaczyć też prawdę. Myślę, że chyba wszyscy z nas mogli odczuć to, że jest to coś szczerego, prawdziwego i oni po tym spektaklu pewnie pójdą, będą o tym mówić, będą sobie wysyłać SMS-y, będą sobie wysyłać posty. Nie tak jak ci prawdziwi, profesjonalni aktorzy, którzy wychodzą i już zapominają o tym wszystkim. Więc posłuchajcie, dostarczyli się nam wielu emocji, wielu takich pewnych przemyśleń. Wspaniała sztuka, wspaniały przekaz, wspaniały message. I cóż, gratuluję. Będziemy was śledzić w przyszłości, tak jak te wasze losy aktorskie będą i wokalne będą się rozwijać, więc myślę, że będziemy mieli sporo pożytku i sporo pociechy jeszcze z wielu z was. A tymczasem wspaniała zabawa, wspaniała przygoda. Jeszcze raz bardzo dziękuję i bardzo się cieszę, że nasza szkoła mogła być takim miejscem dla was, gdzie mogliście to wszystko dla nas przygotować. Także dziękuję.
Chciałybyśmy jeszcze, niech pan dyrektor jeszcze nie schodzi, jeszcze chwilka. Chciałybyśmy w imieniu rodziców i dzieci bardzo podziękować panu dyrektorowi i wszystkim instruktorom, wszystkim tym, którzy pracują z naszymi dziećmi, bo wkładacie w to miejsce ogrom swojego serca i pracy, ale ta praca nie udałaby się, gdyby właśnie nie było tamtego serca. I to serce jest ogromne. Tutaj jest miejsce, gdzie dzieci są traktowane z szacunkiem, z troską, gdzie każdy jest dostrzeżony. I za to jesteśmy bardzo wdzięczni, bo oni tutaj rozwijają się, otwierają się na świat, rozwijają skrzydła i są coraz bardziej odważni i piękne relacje nawiązują. Jesteśmy za to bardzo, bardzo wdzięczni. My zaczniemy od pana dyrektora. Chcemy podziękować bardzo za Moracz i za ten projekt teatralny, który tutaj żyje. A myślę, że dalej już dzieci same chciałyby podziękować.
Na początku chcielibyśmy podziękować pani Asi. Pani Asiu, zapraszamy. Pani Asiu, chcieliśmy pani podziękować za wszystkie rady, za pani wsparcie nasze dla nas ogromne i za to, co wszystko dla nas pani robiła i że pani nas zawsze wspierała i te wszystkie wskazówki, które pani nam dawała. Tak naprawdę, no, przez to ten spektakl był jeszcze świetniejszy dzięki pani. Dziękujemy bardzo.
Teraz zapraszam panią Kasię, zapraszam. I chcielibyśmy wszyscy podziękować pani za to, jak pani nas dobrze przygotowała do tego musicalu. Tak naprawdę bez pani by to się wszystko nie udało. Dziękujemy za przygotowanie do nagrań, za szkolenie nas wokalnie i grupowo, i każdego z osobna. I bardzo dużo pani zawdzięczamy, naprawdę. Dziękuję.
Chcielibyśmy bardzo podziękować drugiej pani Kasi od kostiumów i scenografii. Pani Kasiu? Jest pani takim... Pani przewodzi zespołem, który nie gra, ale grają owoce jego pracy, grają kostiumy, gra scenografia i bez tego wszystkiego ten cały spektakl by po prostu nie wyglądał. I dziękujemy pani za to, że pani tutaj jest z nami i pani tak naprawdę ogarnia to wszystko, czego nie widać, więc... Nie widać, że pani to ogarnia. Widać to wszystko, co pani robi. Więc dziękujemy za to.
Dzień dobry. No to ja poproszę tutaj do pomocy Ignacego i Mikołaja, którzy się zgłosili, i pana Szymona na scenę. No to panie Szymonie, kiedy pan tu będzie iść w zwolnionym tempie, no to ja bym chciała podziękować za wszystkie nasze wspólne zajęcia i w ogóle za pana dobry, fajny humor. I jak na początku przyszłam na te zajęcia, jeszcze przed zajęciami, to jak zobaczyłam pana, to jakby już od razu poczułam, że można panu zaufać i w ogóle, no się otworzyłam, jak zawsze ja. No i bardzo dziękujemy za to, że pan nam pomagał, mówił, jak nagrywać i wszystko, i liczył na nas zawsze całym sercem. I właśnie bardzo chcieliśmy podziękować całą grupą filmową.
Chcielibyśmy także podziękować naszej sekcji technicznej, Konstancji Małek i Maćkowi Bramirskiemu. Tak, mimo że nie widać was na scenie, to wykonujecie kawał dobrej roboty i bez was naprawdę nie dalibyśmy sobie rady, więc dziękujemy bardzo.
Teraz podziękowania dla Heleny, która przewodniczyła całą sekcją makijaży. Czy możemy zawołać Helenę? Helena! 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 Chcielibyśmy ci bardzo podziękować za to, jakie cudowne makijaże nam wymyśliłaś. Jak w ogóle wszyscy nam to namalowaliście razem z grupą Beauty. Tak naprawdę te makijaże dodały takiego smaczku, takiego charakteru do każdej naszej postaci. I to tak jakby dopełnia tą piękną całość, którą wszyscy razem tworzymy. Więc dziękujemy bardzo.
Teraz poprosimy tutaj na środeczek Janka! Chcę ci podziękować, ja też również szczerze, i wszyscy tutaj, którzy jesteśmy, za piękną współpracę z panią Martą i za to, że ciągle, cały czas byłeś aktywny, ciągle takie malutkie rzeczy, po prostu zamawiałeś jakieś materiały, jakieś małe szczegóły, ciągle pracowałeś tak tu, tam, siam, w kół. Dokładnie, wszędzie wszystkiego pilnowałeś. To jest małe rzeczy, ale jak się wszystko kumuluje, to jest po prostu ogromna przysługa.
I na sam koniec chcielibyśmy podziękować naszej ukochanej pani Marcie, bez której by nas tutaj nie było. Pani Marto.
Dziękujemy pani tak naprawdę za wszystko, tak naprawdę za wszystko, bo jakby pani nie było, no to nie byłoby nas tutaj, więc dziękujemy za pani cierpliwość. Za cierpliwość, za to, że...
Bez pani by nas tutaj nie było i nie byłoby Moraczyn Świeter. Dziękujemy jeszcze raz.
Grupa wycyklana.
Ale ładnie pani nam tak
piękne. Raz, dwa, trzy. Szanowni Państwo, to już chyba jest koniec na dzisiaj. Jutro jeszcze mamy dwa spektakle, ale też korzystając z tej okazji zapraszam w niedzielę od 10 do 14 mamy Moracz Happy Day i również będziemy mieli część spektaklu ubiegłorocznego The Lion King w wersji koncertowej, więc myślę, że będzie również sporo wzruszeń. A na dzisiaj to cóż, to kwiaty, objęcia, pocałunki. Dziękujemy za przybycie. Jeszcze raz, tak jak powiedzieliśmy na końcu sobie wszyscy, jesteśmy bardzo wdzięczni pani Marcie Abramczyk. Także z całego serca dziękujemy jej i dziękujemy i dziękujemy. Także wszystkiego dobrego, dobrego wieczoru i cóż, dziękujemy za dzisiejsze spotkanie. Do zobaczenia na kolejnych spektaklach. Thank you.